some of you may know, I have a fairly wide, 12-foot wide projection screen, which is appropriate for 4K video. It's got a reflectance of 1.1. The problem with it is, unfortunately, that because it's got a 1.1 reflectance, there is a hot spot, you know, where the projector beam has a reflection angle that's appropriate to the hot spot, like a mirror does. And in the middle of that hot spot, you see some defects in the screen that come about because the screen gets rolled up into the container that it holds it up there, because the screen is not permanently out. It's rolls up, get out of the way. And most people are able to watch the movie and enjoy it and ignore the defects caused by this hot spot. I'm not, and two or three of the people in this room are not. So I've been trying to figure out something that I can do to fix it. And one of our members who's not here today advocates using a bed sheet. But a 12-foot wide bed sheet, A, doesn't exist. And B, if you can find one, they cost between $250 and $400. And I don't want to spend that much money for a bed sheet. So I didn't know what to do. And I wasn't going to replace my screen anyway, but gee whiz, it's kind of fun to experiment. So I shopped online, and lo and behold, I found a 14-foot wide tablecloth that was white that cost $17. Yeah. So, you know, so I bought this damn tablecloth and stretched it out and set it on my screen, and I had these guys come over and take a look at it for critique. And damn, it was not as good as a $3,000, but it was much better than a $17 price tag would indicate it ought to be. We did some measurements on it. The standard bed sheet that is recommended has a thread count of about 200 threads per inch, okay? That was $250 for a big one. The maybe if you wanted to go 4K, you ought to get a 400 thread count sheet. That costs $450, okay, in the size I'm interested in. We put my tablecloth, my $17 tablecloth, under a microscope and measured the thread count. 40. 40. Well, if 200 is barely adequate for 1080p, 40 ought to be horrible. And it wasn't. And that's the miracle. Wow. For $17, you can get a 12-foot wide screen that looks acceptable. End of
report.
Are the threads the same size?
Huh?
Are the threads the same size?
Well, the threads are bigger because there's only 40 of them per inch instead of 200 per inch.
So more reflective surface, right?
Well, that's part of the explanation, I think, is that the gaps are still small.
But it's a larger surface. On
because the threads are bigger, yeah.
So it's a plus.
So you leave it permanently attached somehow to yours?
I don't use it. I continue to use the one that irritates me.
Okay.
Because the one that irritates me cost me $3,000. And I'm just not, you know, that interested in replacing it.
Can you sit in a different spot in the room? And
well, see, that's the interesting thing. Okay. I have friends come over and watch movies with me from time to time. And when I do that, I sit in the control spot, which is way off to the side, and I let my friends sit in the middle. So they see the irritating hot spot, and I'm off to the side, and I don't see it at all. I'm happy. Yeah.
What is the irritating consequence of that hotspot? What does it look like?
Any minor defect in the surface, okay, gets magnified because the hotspot is bright and the minor defects are not so bright. When you're not seeing the hotspot, the screen itself and the defects are about the same darkness and you don't see them, but they become obvious. And here's the problem, because I have my screen gets rolled up, it gets rolled up, and at regular intervals related to the size of the roll, you see horizontal stripes on the screen.
Dave Clark had the same phenomena.
Hmm?
Dave Clark had the same phenomena in his screen.
In his screen. And I will say this, had I known that, I would probably not have bought a 1.1, I would probably have bought a 0.9 reflectance screen. Because I'm using my projector at the lowest possible brightness, economy mode, and it's still plenty bright enough image. And the reason I bought the 1.1 was because I wanted it to be a bright image. Well, it turns out it's not necessary to do that. So if I had known better, I would have bought a 0.9 or 0.8 screen and would not have had the hotspot problem, and I think everything would be fine. So those of you who want to have a nice big screen and not spend more than $17, I can give you the references to the table.
Write to mypillow.com now that he's got those sheets and have him custom make one for you of the right size.
Well, as I said, the my screen is 12 feet wide. It's not 12 feet diagonal, it's 12 feet wide. So it's about 13 and a half, 14 feet diagonal. So it's a big screen. And finding a bed sheet that size ain't easy.
Yeah.
Anyway, so it's a tablecloth. Tablecloth's the way to go. And if you want a tablecloth email address, I can give.
This program has been a production of the Southeastern Michigan Woofer and Tweeter Marching Society. Opinions expressed during this program are those of the individual speaking and not necessarily the opinion of the Southeastern Michigan Woofer and Tweeter Marching Society.